Hi viewers, next topic is tunnel effect. Okay, so tunnel effect. Tunneling means what? Even though if you don't have sufficient energy to cross any wall or anything, then if you cross yourself with less energy, then that is called tunnel effect, right? That is the meaning of tunnel. And here, what is the meaning of, what is the tunnel explanation? Here, consider a potential barrier of height with E is less than. So height is a potential barrier, height is V. Here not written, potential barrier of height is V with E is less than V. Okay, so V is very much high, so E is the energy of the particle. Okay, energy of the particle. So here V potential is very much high, means its height is very much, its energy is very much high. That is the meaning of this. And next, the de Broglie waves that correspond to the particle are partly reflected and partly transmitted. That means here de Broglie wave is considered, particle is considered. De Broglie, according to de Broglie, means whatever particle that has, it may travels in the form of like this. And it strike to the wall, and it sometime it come back, means it reflects in this direction. That is a reflection. And part of this total, out of the total energy, part of energy come back, and part of light goes outside, means transmit it. Okay, so that is the meaning of the second point. And the next point is the particle has a certain probability of passing through the potential barrier and emerging on the other side. So particle has certain probability, means chance, certain chance, there is a chance also, okay, to pass through the potential barrier of barrier and emerging on the other side. So particle, there is a chance to penetrate this wall and come outside. That is the meaning of this. And the next is, the particle lacks the energy to go on other top of barrier. So upside is energy lacked, so particle cannot move upside, only it has to move like this only. That is lacking. The next, but the particle can tunnel through the walls. Tunneling means it easily penetrates and goes outside. The higher the barrier, the wider it is. So suppose a higher the barrier, means a barrier height is very much high, then this is very much wide like this. When the height increases, this is also increases. Okay, when height increases, this width also increases. Next, the higher the, next one, the lesser the chance that the particle can get through it. Okay, so then it is a wider like this, then part, there is a less chance to penetrate tunnel the particle this side. Okay, if it is a height is less than its width also less, then there is a more chance, not less, more chance to tunnel through the this barrier particles. But here, as the height is high, then barrier width is also high, less, there is a less chance to go outside. Next, consider a beam of identical particles. Okay, so let me consider the beam of, means beam means all the many particles are moving in straight direction, that is called generally beam of identical particles, all of which have the kinetic energy. So then all they have, all may have the kinetic energy E. The beam is incident from region 1 on the potential barrier of height V and a width L. See, already potential barrier, there are how many regions? Three regions it is doing. 1, 2, and 3, like this region. So see, what are those three regions? I will show you. So this side is a first region, and a potential barrier is a second region, and this side is a third region, like this. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so like this, three regions. Okay. on both side of the barrier potential energy is zero. Okay, so on both side, so particle is free this side and this side, but particle is not free at the barrier. So that is why here the potential energy is high and this side is zero. Why? It is a very, it is a free particle, these two sides. And next, this means that no force acting on the particle in the region 1 and 3. So the meaning of this is what? It is a free, means in the region 1 and in the region 3, particles cannot undergo any external force, means no force acts on it. And next, the wave function psi 1 plus represent the incoming particles moving towards the barrier from the region 1. See, already upside is given, like this it is a barrier, okay, it is a region 2, region 1 and region 3. Okay, so psi 1 plus means the particle is coming from region 1 and entering into the region 2. That is the meaning of this. And next, same here, psi minus means the wave function psi minus represent the reflected particle moving to the left away from the barrier. Left away from the barrier means, see the diagram, then you can understand. Psi plus means coming like this, psi minus means going back side. Okay, psi plus is forward, minus means backward, that is reflection. Next, with the wave function psi 3 plus represent the transmitted particle to the region 3. Psi 3 plus means a particle which is transmitting in the region, it is moving in the region 3. So in the region 3 is there, in this region psi 3 plus is given, means a tunneled particle, it is a tunnel or a tunneled particle. So it is psi 1 plus, psi 1 minus and psi 3 plus. Okay, that is the meaning of this. The next, the transmission probability, so is denoted by T, for a particle to pass through the barrier is given by, it is the equation, T is equals number of particle transmitted by number of particle incident. So that that gives transmission probability, and it has expression T is equals to e power minus 2 L by h cut under root 2m v minus e. So we have this derivations, so already I have uploaded one video for this derivation also, that is a rectangular potential barrier. So please watch that video, then you can understand how we get this equation. There I explained. Okay friends, thank you.